Good day, everybody. In this video, I would like to talk about recurrence of earthquakes, so how often they can happen. And we'll also talk about probability of certain earthquakes to exceed certain period of time. So let's start with the chart. I took this chart from a book by this researcher, Briaud, and I'm gonna put a link in the description of the video so that you can look up this book by yourself. And this chart actually summarizes lots of data, the one that we can use to predict how often this particular earthquake can happen. I remember that what we're talking about, it's about approximate time. So it's not exact time, let's say in like 150 years. No, that's not gonna happen, but it's gonna give us at least some idea how long we can wait for maybe stronger earthquake and how long it's going to take to reoccur. So you will see that here on the left hand side we have data that is it's actually seismic empirical data, and this data was used by Gutenberg and Richter to came up with this empirical correlation. So this is a logarithm of the number of earthquakes per year of certain magnitude m, and these values a and b, this is just regional parameters that we use. So we can actually place them here on the chart, and they will create this nice exponential line. So it actually works really well. The only problem is when the earthquake it's a little bit stronger than 6, so this one actually doesn't give very good estimations. So if it will have like a lot of small earthquake with the magnitudes less than 6, we can use this part of the curves or line, and we're going to use this for prediction. So here on this chart, you see that it says recurrence interval. So this is in years. It's a log scale. The original data devised by Gutenberg and Richter that only use annual number of earthquakes. That comes here from this formula. So you see that if we want to actually estimate how long it's going to take to stronger earthquake to reoccur, we're going to use what is called characteristic model developed by this researcher. So this part of the chart. So you see that for this particular for earthquakes which are greater than 6, we also need to consider geologic data such as fault length and historic slip rate. So in this particular case, that's what we need to do, and this will be a little bit improvement compared to the Gutenberg's Richter model. So now let's see how we can use it. For example, if we have a magnitude of 6, how long is going to take to reoccur for this particular earthquake. So we're just going to look at the chart, and we're going to look that magnitude 6 is here. So we can still use this exponential line of the Gutenberg and Richter's model, and then it's going to give us number here. So this will be log scale. Unfortunately, in this chart, you don't have these little marks for log scale, so we have to have some estimation. So because this is log scale, we assume that it's about 200 years. So approximately 200 years. So please remember that it's not gonna give you exact number, exact estimate. It just give you some approximation how long it may take for this particular earthquake to take place, right? And if you look at again at this chart, you will see that if there's a relatively weaker earthquake with relatively smaller magnitudes, they're gonna happen more often compared to the earthquakes with very high magnitude. For example, for the earthquake that just took place recently in Turkey in Syria, so that the value was, the magnitude was more than 7. So this actually doesn't even provide good estimates because it's very difficult to estimate how long it's going to take. But let's say even was about 7, so somewhere in this area, it can take from I believe from 500 to 1000 years to take place. Okay, so this is just to give you some idea how you can get some quick estimation of earthquake reoccurrence. And now let's look at probabilities. So how we can use probabilities and how we can also estimate the return period of this particular event or earthquake. So you see that P here in this formula is probability and T is the return period. And usually we use it in years and L is the period of time. So L is going to be in years. So now let's see how we can use this formula to estimate the return period of an earthquake that has 10% probability of exceedance in 50 years. So it's 1 in 50 chances that this particular day that there would be earthquake that would exceed this magnitude in the next 50 years. So what we're going to do, we will rearrange this formula for T because that's what we need to get. So if we arrange the formula, we're going to have something like T is equal 1 divided by 1 minus P power 1 divided by L. So now if we put numbers here, we're going to have that we have 10% of probability. So here we still have 1. Here we have 1 minus P. So the probability is 10%. I'm going to write 0.1. And it's over 50 years. So L will be 50 years. 1 divided by 50. So that will approximately give us 475 years. So that will be the answer. So the return period of earthquake that has probability of 10% of exceedance in 50 years will be 475 years. Well, thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.